nervous.
This pretty woman.
Dude, you're Julia Roberts and Richard Gere is about to come pick you up.
Do I look okay? Do I look funny? Why are these pockets here? Why am I wearing these stupid pants? They're too tapered.
You can't think like this. You have to be positive.
Mr. Flarsky?
Wish me luck, man.
Yeah, you don't need luck, man. She said it was okay. Luck is for losers. You got destiny on your side.
Good. Fred, you body body.
Doesn't mean anything. Fred, put your seatbelt on. Take care of my friend. All right?
Hammer time. Here we go, Seth Rogen, back on the big screen.
He's back.
Long shot, O'Shea Jackson Jr. in there, and Charlize Theron. Great cast on this.
Who would have thought you could put Seth Rogen and Charlize Theron in a rom-com? It works. The sparks fly. It doesn't happen right away, but I enjoyed that they built up to it because this movie is really smart about establishing who these characters are, respectively. They're the perfect foil. So she's on top of her game. She's the U.S. Secretary of State, eyeing a run as president, and he's a struggling journalist who just lost his job. Their character connects. She's a couple years older than him. She used to babysit for him, and she was basically his first crush. So they reunite, and she eventually hires him to be her speechwriter. And it actually is a lot sharper and wittier than the trailers make it seem. It's also edgy and raunchy. There's a tiny bit of action in it as well, so it ticks a ton of comedic boxes.
Do we have another clip?
Yeah, we do. Let's take a look.
But how does that work with you? Do you, like, date?
Yeah, I date. Generally, you know, with people who have similar lifestyles to me, people who travel a lot. It's hard to keep those things alive. I mean, who wants to follow me around the world and hope I have 5 minutes to be affectionate?
Yeah.
And honestly, guys don't really want to date women who are more powerful than them.
For president of the United States.
Okay, so interesting. It looks like you have two genres in this film. Political satire, romantic comedy. Did these two ideas complement each other or clash in this film?
They beautifully get balanced out because right from the get-go, the movie is concerned more with establishing who these characters are, what their attributes are, and how you could find a way to bring such different people together. And it does that in favor of, like, the gags off the top. It's still very funny. It's got a lot of physical slapstick stuff. Some of the stuff doesn't always hit the mark, but Jonathan Levine, the director, worked with Seth Rogen before in The Night Before, and he's done the rom-com stuff before. You know, we've seen it in Knocked Up, Zach and Miri Make a Porno. Charlize Theron, she's done a little bit of comedy, you know, like in Tully and Young Adult. She is a force in this movie. There's one scene where she has to negotiate a hostage release, and she's under the influence. It is an all-time classic, so she is able to finally bust out and show these comedic chops. It's also got some great elements. It's like Boyz II Men are in it. It's got awesome 80s and 90s pop songs.
I'm in.
Had you at Boyz II Men. Also, Andy Serkis plays like this ghoulish, like, network executive. Bob Odenkirk plays the president of the United States. He just wants to get back on TV. And Alexander Skarsgård plays sort of a mock version of Trudeau as the Canadian prime minister. So it's got eclectic acting, very satirical wit, and I hope it does have a showing at the box office.
Yeah, okay, so I'll ask you, how many hammers, and given the fact Endgame is dominating right now, will it find an audience?
It's not going to be number one, but I think there's a great niche here for people looking for an excellent romantic comedy. It's one of the funniest films of the year so far. I'm going 4 out of 5.
Oh!
Yeah!
Seth Rogen.
You got a winner.
I want to check it out this weekend.
Yeah.
All right.